So hello everyone, we started with today's lecture. In yesterday's lecture we completed aphorism number 249, 250, 251 and 252. These four aphorisms we covered in yesterday's lecture. Now in today's lecture we are going to start with aphorism number 253. So prior this we will revise the previous aphorisms in shortly. So, in previous lectures, the main themes of aphorisms are that is, the physician must know. That is, we started with homeopathic posology. In this, we are going to discuss the two important points. First one, that is the mode of employing the remedies, knowledge about the mode of employing the remedies, and second one, the science of improvement. In this, we studied the first point, that is regarding the knowledge of physician. The physician must having the knowledge of disease, knowledge of medicine, and knowledge of how to apply the medicinal knowledge to the disease knowledge. And along with this, he also know about the knowledge of diet and regimen that the patient should follow during his treatment, and what should be the mode of using these remedies. Means after the selection of remedy, what is the duty of physician regarding these remedies? That is, what should be the second prescription? It may be repetition of the previous medicine, it may be the change of potency, it may be the change of the remedy, or it may be the use of another remedy. So this may be the mode of using the remedies after the selection of remedies. So physician must have this knowledge about diet and regimen and the mode of using the remedies. Then next theme we studied, that is about the mode of employing the remedies in chronic diseases. So what is the mode of employing the remedies in chronic diseases? As we know that acute diseases having the high intensity of signs and symptoms, and due to fast metabolic process there is need of frequent repetition. On the contrary, in chronic diseases, as deep acting, long acting miasmatic medicines gets indicated, there is no need of frequent repetition in chronic diseases. So repeat the dose if indicated, and after the exhaustion of action of previous medicine, that is we repeat the medicine when the action of the previous medicine gets exhausted in chronic diseases. So this is the view of Dr. Hahnemann regarding the chronic diseases in fifth edition of Organon of Medicine. But after the completion of sixth edition, he put for the note that while using the high potencies in chronic diseases, or when we use the exact simile of the disease condition or the patient, we can use the frequent repetition, and that frequent repetition mainly indicated for the new method of giving the medicine to the patient, that is regarding the LM potency, or also we call it as a 50 millisimole potency. Then the next theme was regarding the repetition of the dose. In that, in case of acute diseases as well as chronic diseases, same medicine should not be repeated in the same potency, because what the medicine can do in given potency has already done. That is, what is the work of that same potency? It is over. So same potency cannot be repeated. When you have to repeat the same medicine, you have to increase the potency of that medicine, and then you can use that medicine, and that is able to stimulate your vital force. Then next theme is how to increase the power of medicine. In this, power of medicine can be increased by dynamizing the medicine at each and every time prior to administration. Means you have to increase the potency or the power of that medicine by dynamizing processes, by succussions and trituration, that is before or prior to the administration of that medicine. Then next, regarding the antidote, using of antidote. So what is antidote? Antidotal medicines are those medicines which neutralizes the action of previous medicine, that we call it as an antidote. So there is need of antidote if there is medicinal aggravation or a wrong selection of medicine. So when there is a medicinal aggravation or a wrong selection of medicine in a patient, then at that time we use the antidote to neutralize the action of that previous medicine. Then we studied about the medicinal aggravation. So what is mean by medicinal aggravation? In that, After recording of a case, a medicine is selected in a specific potency. And during follow-up, if there is appearance of some new symptoms which are not belonging to the aggravation of the disease or which are not giving relief, they are the symptoms of the medicine given and there is a need of antidote. Means medicinal aggravation means these are the symptoms that are related to the medicines that is given to the patient and these are not the symptoms related to the disease condition of the patient or that aggravated symptom cannot give the relief to the patient. If the that symptom give relief to the patient, that we call it as a homeopathic aggravation. But these are the symptoms that are related to the medicine. So we have to decrease the effect of that medicine and to neutralize the effect of that medicine, we have to use the antidote in that cases when there is a medicinal aggravation in a patient. Then we studied about the acute disease and wrong selection. As it is expected that in a case of acute diseases, patient should feels better within few hours. But on the contrary, when physician comes to the conclusion that he has selected a wrong medicine and the patient is becoming worse and worse, he should antidote the medicine and by recording this case, another most similar medicine must be given. As we know that acute conditions are of short duration and if we use the exact medicine in that acute condition, that exact medicine can affect in a within few hours. But when there is no recovery within few hours, the physician comes to the conclusion that he has selected the wrong medicines to the patient and the patient becoming worse and worse. And at that time, he should antidote the medicine by recording the case and another most medicine must be given to the patient in acute conditions. Then next thing we studied about that is repetition of same medicine or repetition of medicine in same potency. In that repetition of same medicine in same potency is indicated or needed in those patients who having alternating diseases or alternating symptoms. So what is mean by alternating symptoms? Alternating symptoms are one which alternates with one another. In that we take example as that is constipation alternates with diarrhea. Then body ache alternates with abdominal pain. These are the alternating symptoms that alternate with one another. In that case, we have to use the repetition of the same medicine with the same potency. Then at that time only that potency may act. Otherwise, you have to increase the potency while repeating the same medicine. Then alternating symptoms are those symptoms where two disease processes of same disease alternates with one another. In that, we also take example like loose motion alternates with rheumatism, constipation alternates with diarrhea. So some of these symptoms are related to the abrotanum. So in that cases, we have to repeat the same medicine with the same potency. Then we studied about that is removal of the obstacles in the way of cure. So what is mean by removal of the obstacles? In that patient comes to us, after that we recording the chronic case and after the selection of an appropriate homeopathic medicine by taking all the question which is needed for that case. So if the patient is not feeling better, it is a sure sign that there is some obstacles in the way of cure. Means we select the proper medicine, exact medicine to the patient. We follow all the guidelines or do the all questions while giving the medicine and patient is taking question while taking the medicine also. But something there happens that stop the cure of the patient. And in that case, we must show that there are some obstacles in the way of cure that becomes the difficult to cure the patient and these obstacles in the way, that is we have to remove that obstacle first in the way of cure, then patient becomes permanently cured. So these obstacles may be the, that is some maintaining causes. So first we have to remove that maintaining causes or the obstacles in the way of cure and then only patient becomes cured permanently. So this is regarding the Removal of the obstacles in the way of cure that we explained in aphorism number 252. Now in today's lecture, we are starting with aphorism number 253. So starting with aphorism 253, first I will read the aphorism 253. Among the signs that in all diseases, especially in such as are of an acute nature, inform us of a slight commencement of amelioration or aggravation that is not perceptible to everyone, the state of mind and the whole demeanor of the patient are the most certain and instructive. In the case of ever so slight an improvement, we observe a great degree of comfort, increased calmness and freedom of the mind, higher spirits, a kind of return of natural state. In the case of ever so small a commencement of aggravation, we have, on the contrary, the exact opposite of this, a constrained, helpless, pitiable state of the disposition of the mind, of the whole demeanor and all gestures, postures and actions, which may be easily perceived in close observation but cannot be described in words. So this is regarding the signs of aggravation and amelioration. So what are the signs of aggravation and amelioration? In this, aggravation means there is increase the frequency of the symptoms which are present or which give more discomfort to the patient, that we call it as a aggravation. And amelioration means there is decrease in the present symptom of the patient or which will give the relief to the patient, that condition we called it as a amelioration. So there are signs of amelioration and signs of aggravation. So in this, they explain about the signs of amelioration. In what are the signs that indicate us the patient is in amelioration state? So in this, there is a greater degree of comfort, the patient feeling a greater degree of comfort in signs of amelioration. Then there is increased calmness, then freedom of mind, then higher spirit, a kind of return of the natural state. So these are the signs of amelioration, means patient is going towards the state of cure. So in this, first sign is that is greater degree of comfort, means patient is feeling very comfortable, that is there is no any restlessness, no any thinking or no any tension regarding to the different situations in the life to the patient. So the greater degree of comfort is the first sign of amelioration. Then second sign, it is indicated as that is increased calmness, means patient feeling very calm, his mind, his body, all in the calm state. Then third one, freedom of mind, means his mind is freedom from all the thinking, all the anxiety, all the worries, all the fears. That is freedom of mind. And fourth one, that is higher spirits, a kind of return of the natural state. Means higher spirit means he is doing his regular duty in a very accurately manner or in a calmness, in a very calmness. That is he having a higher spirits. That is his mind, his body, all in the state of calmness and in a good state. That there is a kind of return of a natural state, means he can do each and every work very properly in that case. So these are the signs of amelioration, and when we see these signs of amelioration, we think that patient is going towards the state of permanent cure. So these are the signs of amelioration. Then signs of aggravation. What are the signs of aggravation? In that, a first one, that is constrained. Then second one, helpless. Then pitiable state of the mind, of the whole man and of all the gestures and postures. So what is the signs of aggravation? That is helplessness. That is he cannot think that that is helpless or hopelessness. He cannot think there is any good thing in the in his life. There is all bad is happening in his mind and body is totally distract. So these are the different साइंस दैट इज साइंस ऑफ एम्यूल सॉरी साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन एंड इन दिस दैट इज अ कंस्ट्रेंट मीन्स देर इज समथिंग दैट हैविंग दैट लिमिट्स यू मीन्स कंस्ट्रेंट मीन्स यू हैव लिमिट्स दैट इज यू कैनॉट डू ऑल द थिंग्स इन योर लाइफ दैट इज समथिंग दैट लिमिट्स यू दैट इज अ साइन ऑफ एग्रीवेशन और दैट इज कंस्ट्रेंट कंस्ट्रेंट मीन्स समथिंग दैट लिमिट्स यू दैट कैनॉट गिव यू अ फ्रीडम इन द लाइफ एंड द थर्ड वन दैट इज पिटिएबल स्टेट ऑफ द माइंड ऑफ द होल मैन एंड ऑल इज जेस्चर्स पोस्चर्स एंड एक्शंस दैट इज हिज माइंड इज इन अ स्टेट ऑफ डिप्रेशन ही इज नॉट फीलिंग फ्रेश और अ होल मैन एंड ऑल हिज जेस्चर्स हिज पोस्चर्स एंड हिज एक्शंस ऑल इन अ स्टेट ऑफ डिसीज कंडीशन दे थिंकिंग अबाउट ओनली अबाउट द डिसीज कंडीशन सो दिस इज द साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन एंड इफ वी सी दिस साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन मीन्स अवर पेशेंट इज नॉट गोइंग टूअर्ड द स्टेट ऑफ क्योर बट इट इज बिकम मोर वर्स एंड वर्स सो दिस आर द साइंस ऑफ एम्यूलरेशन एंड साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन दिस इज एक्सप्लेनिंग इन एफोरिज्म नंबर 253 All of you understanding, all of you listening? Yes? Karishma kahat hai ka? Sagyanna aawaj yeto na vyavasthit? Okay. So we studied aphorism number 253 that is regarding the science of aggravation and science of amelioration. The next aphorism is aphorism number 254. So what this aphorism state? Aphorism number 254. The other new or increased symptoms, or on the contrary, the new diminution of the original ones without any addition of new ones. Will soon dispel all doubts from the mind of the attentively observing and investigating practitioner with regards to the aggravation and amelioration. Though there are among patients persons who are either incapable of giving an account of this amelioration or aggravation or are unwilling to confess it. So, this aphorism indicates that is how to identify whether it is a aggravation or it is a amelioration means there are some condition we cannot indicate that it is a aggravation or it is a amelioration Yes, can you listen? Okay, आता है तो का? Okay, so we will seeing the aphorism number 254. Please don't edit anything on screen. Recording is so we started with aphorism number 254 that is how to identify whether it is aggravation or amelioration in this is aggravation so there occurs intensification of natural disease symptoms new symptoms are added patient is not feeling better that we called it as a disease aggravation so in these aphorisms these are connected aphorisms aphorism number 254 255 to 258 so first I will read the aphorisms and then I will explain the explanation of these aphorisms as these are all related aphorisms so first we see the aphorism number 254 Then aphorism number 255 in this Dr. Hahnemann explained about that is, but even with such individuals, we may convince ourselves on this point by going with them through all the symptoms enumerated in our notes of the disease one by one and finding that they complain of no new unusual symptoms in addition to these and that none of the old symptoms are worse. If this be the case and if an improvement in the disposition and mind have already been observed, the medicine must have effected positive diminution of the disease, or if the sufficient time have not yet elapsed for this, it will soon effect it. If now the improvement delay too long in making its appearance, this depends either on some error of conduct on the part of the patient or on the other interfering circumstances. So this is aphorism number 255. Then aphorism number 256, that is, on the other hand, if the patient mentions the occurrence of some fresh accidents and the symptoms of importance, signs that the medicine chosen has not been strictly homeopathic, even though he should good, that is, naturally assures us that he feels better, as it is not infrequently the case in the patient with a lung abscess, we must not believe this assurance but regard his state as aggravated, as it will soon be perfectly apparent it is. Then aphorism number 257, the true physician will take care to avoid making favorite remedies of medicines, the employment of which he has by chance perhaps found often useful and which he has had opportunities of using with good effects. If he do so, some remedies of rarer use, which would have been more homeopathically suitable, consequently more serviceable, will often be neglected. And then last aphorism, that is aphorism number 258, the true practitioner, moreover, will not in his practice with mistrustful weakness neglect the employment of those remedies that he may now and then have employed with bad effects owing to an selection from his own fault, therefore, or avoid them for other false reasons, as that they were unhomeopathic for the cause of disease before him. He must bear in mind the truth that medicinal agents, that one alone invariably deserves the preference by similarity to the totality of the characteristic symptoms, and that no partly prejudices should interfere with this serious choice. So these are aphorism number 255 to 258, and all these aphorisms explain as, that is, the science of improvement. And in science of improvement, in 254 we studied about the science of amelioration and science of aggravation. Then how to identify whether it is aggravation or amelioration. For this reason, the aggravation is divided into different parts. First one, disease aggravation, second, medicinal aggravation, and third, homeopathic aggravation. So what is mean by disease aggravation? That is, there occurs intensification of the natural disease symptoms. When there is increase in the natural disease symptoms, we call it as a disease aggravation. New symptoms are added, the patient is not feeling better. So in that case, the patient is not feeling better in the disease aggravation. And what are the causes of that disease aggravation? The medicine selected is wrong, potency is low than needed. Then obstacles are not removed when there is occurrence of disease aggravation. So that is how to identify the aggravation. So for this reason, you must know there are different aggravations. It may be disease aggravation, it may be medicinal aggravation, or it may be homeopathic aggravation. So what is mean by disease aggravation? So disease aggravation means there occurs intensification of natural disease symptoms, means increase in the natural disease symptoms, that we call it as a disease aggravation. In that, new symptoms are added and patient is not feeling better. In that, what should be the causes of disease aggravation? That is, medicine selected is wrong, potency is low than needed, then obstacles are not removed. That is, what the medicine select, it must be a wrong medicine. Then potency we select, it must be a low potency than needed. And third one, that is, there may be some obstacles in the way of cure, that is not removed. So this is disease aggravation. Then second one, medicinal aggravation. So what is mean by medicinal aggravation? That is, after selection of medicine, there is aggravation. Patient is not feeling better. There is addition of new symptoms, which are symptoms of medicine given. So medicinal aggravation means, that is, this aggravation occurs after the selection of remedy, and this aggravation or symptoms are related to the aggravation of the patient, or these are the symptoms which are related to the medicine. So in that aggravation we call it as a medicinal aggravation. Then what are the causes that occurs the medicinal aggravation? In that is selection of higher and highest potency, means when we select the high potency, higher potency or a highest potency, in that case we will see the medicinal aggravation. And when we use the unnecessary repetition of the medicine, in that case also we find that is medicinal aggravation. So these are the causes that causes the medicinal aggravation. First one, that is when we select the higher and highest potency, and second one, that is when we use the unnecessary repetition of the medicine, in that case the patient may suffer from the medicinal aggravation. And medicinal aggravation means these are the symptoms that is related to the medicinal symptoms, means these are not the symptoms that are related to the disease condition of the patient, but these are the symptoms related to the symptoms of that medicine. So we call it as a medicinal aggravation. And the third one, that is homeopathic aggravation. What is meant by homeopathic aggravation? That is, although there is intensification of signs and symptoms, but here with patient is feeling better. So in homeopathic aggravation, there is intensification of signs and symptoms, means what the symptoms are present in a patient. Patient comes to us with signs and symptoms, there is increase in the that signs and symptoms of the patient, and but along with that intensification of signs and symptoms, but here with a patient is feeling better, means patient having a feeling of betterness. So that we call it as a homeopathic aggravation. And in that, what are the causes that causes the homeopathic aggravation are, that is, selection of medicine is correct, potency is correct, repetition is correct, and the obstacles are removed. But there are few persons of which it is very difficult to get idea about aggravation or amelioration. So in that way we can classify, it is a disease aggravation, it is a medicinal aggravation, or it is homeopathic aggravation. So homeopathic aggravation, it is an intensification of present signs and symptoms of the patient, and this is a good sign that our patient is on the way of cure. So in that case, what should be the causes of homeopathic aggravation? That is, the selected medicine is correct, selected potency is correct, selected repetition is correct, and we remove all the obstacles in the way of cure, and patient is on the way of cure. So that we called it as a homeopathic aggravation. So in this way we can identify whether it is aggravation or amelioration, or which type of aggravation, as it is a disease aggravation, or it is a medicinal aggravation, or it is a homeopathic aggravation. Then in that, they also explain about, that is, follow-up recording or re-recording. In this they explain as, for such patient follow-up recording is very essential. While re-recording, physician should go through each and every symptom which he has noted in the first visit. He should observe whether there is addition of some new symptoms, whether symptoms aggravated or they are as it is. If no addition of new symptom, original symptoms are diminished, it is a positive sign and that medicine has worked positively. So in that aphorism, they also explain as follow-up of re-recording, means when the patient comes to physician, in that case he has to record the properly ki which symptoms are present, which symptoms are becoming worse, which symptoms are becoming ameliorated or decreased. In that case, for such patient, follow-up recording is very essential, means at every follow-up you have to keep the record of that follow-up, and in that, while re-recording, physician should go through the each and every symptom which he has noted in the first visit. Means when patient comes first time, we have record all the details. When patient comes next time, then we can confirm with the first recording as the first symptoms are decreased or increased. In that way, we come to the conclusion it is aggravated or ameliorated. So new symptoms, whether symptoms aggravated or they are as it is. And if no addition of new symptom is there, original symptom also diminished, it is a positive sign, that is a sign of improvement, that the medicine worked positively. Then they also explain as a signs of wrong similimum. What are the signs of wrong similimum? In this, the signs of wrong similimum are, that is, few of the patients are there who in follow-up say that, doctor, I am feeling better. Although there is addition of some new symptoms, they should be assessed clinically. So there are some selection of wrong similimum, means at the follow-up patient may think that he is feeling better, but clinically you have to verify, that is his by doing his blood investigation, his urine investigation, or by a clinical examination, you have to work out that the disease condition is increasing or decreasing. At some times patient may mistaken the feeling as a it may be a better feeling, and you do not depend only on that feeling of better. Along with this feeling of better, you have to clinically examine the patient, and then you come to the conclusion that it is a sign of improvement or it is a sign of worse, or you have selected a similar medicine or you have selected the wrong similimum. Then there are some disadvantages of favorite remedies. So what are the disadvantages of favorite remedy? So in that, what is mean by favorite remedies? So favorite remedies are those remedies which are also called as a specific remedies, which are fixed in the mind of a physician for a specific diseases, like when patient comes to you of a warts. So in your mind, first medicine comes, that is Thuja. When patient comes to you with a constipation, the medicine comes in mind, that is Naxomica. So these are the some of the example that there is some specific remedy for a specific disease condition, and that we called it as a favorite remedy of that physician. And doing the practice of that favorite medicine, it is a very wrong. You have to take the case of that patient. You have to find out the similimum of that patient, and then you have to prescribe the medicine to that patient. That is, these medicines which are specific medicines or which are favorite remedies, this having disadvantages. So if physician uses such remedies with good effect, other remedies which are more homeopathic and useful than these remain obscured. Means when the patient physician using only these favorite remedies, the very good medicine in homeopathic may remain obscured in the materia medica, or they should be neglected. But this medicine can do better effect than this favorite remedy. So you have to avoid using that favorite remedy or the specific remedy. So these are the disadvantages of using the favorite remedies or a specific remedies. Then along with this, they also explain lastly, that is, never be prejudiced to any remedy. That is, while prescribing the remedies, you must be a physician, must be a unprejudiced observer. That is explaining in aphorism number 6, that is Dr. Hahnemann has taught, if so we are explaining the last part of the aphorisms, that is never be prejudiced to any remedy, means physician should be unprejudiced according to the aphorism number 6 by Dr. Hahnemann, that he taught, if one is prejudiced, there is a possibility of correct observation, or there may be possibility of wrong observation, or there may be possibility of null observation. So homeopath for a remedy must be unprejudiced. So this is the explanation of aphorism number 255 to aphorism number 258. In this I will again repeat the aphorisms from the another book, that is sure signs of improvement in a case after the administration of similimum, means what are the signs of improvement after the administration of a similimum. In this they explain as an improvement in the state of mind and disposition. So what are the signs of improvement means, that is after the giving medicine to the patient, what are the changes that we see in the patient, or what
how can we say that the patient is going towards the state of improvement? That is, after the selection of medicine, what are the signs of improvement? In this, first we feel that is an improvement in the state of mind and disposition, means patient feeling a better, that is a state of mind and disposition. Then second, no appearance of any new unusual symptoms, means after giving the medicine, patient don't having any appearance of new symptom or any unusual symptom. Then third one, that is diminution of the old symptoms, and more of the old symptoms are worse, in that the old symptoms may get disappear or more of the old symptoms are worse. That is, the old symptoms may get disappear or there is some aggravation in the old symptoms that may get worse. That is the signs of improvement, or the state of aggravation in the patient is apprehended if the points out some fresh accidents and some symptoms of importance, even though he might assure his physician that he feels better. That is, there may be some state of aggravation, in that the state of aggravation in the patient is apprehended if he points out some fresh accidents and some symptoms of importance, even though he might assure his physician that he feels better. If there is appearance of new symptoms, but along with this, the patient is feeling better. In that, the Dr. Hanuman gave example as occurrence of lung abscess in a patient is surely a bad sign, even if the patient feels temporarily better. That is, in some cases, the patient may feel better. I explained that point, that is patient feeling better, but the physician have to note, is there really a better feeling or there is a temporary better feeling to the patient, and how the clinical state of that patient. For this reason, physician must clinically observe to the patient by the investigation also and by with the clinical examination also, and then he can faith on the patient, that is he having a better feeling. So in that, they gave the example as, that is the patient having a lung abscess, and temporarily he feels better. In that case, the physician not depend on that temporary feeling better feeling, as the lung abscess is already a bad sign. So for this reason, the worsening of the patient condition will be clearly made and manifest very soon thereafter. So for this reason, only that temporary feeling of better is not important in that case. For this reason, the physician has to clinically verify the patient and do the another treatment or follow next treatment to the patient. Then in this one question to the homeopathic physician, what is the one question that gives Dr. Hanuman to the homeopathic physician, as the homeopathic physician should always be guided by the totality of symptom in each case, means homeopathic physician should take note of totality of symptoms in each case. He should never fall into the habit of making favorite medicines for nosologically labeled disease condition, means if there is constipation, give Naxomica. If there is allergic rhinitis, give Allium Cepa or give Arsenic. If there is joint pain, give Rustox, Bryonia. So that is, he should never fall into the habit of making favorite medicines for nosologically labeled disease condition, and such a habit will induce him to overlook rare remedies which might happen to be indicated in any particular case. So for this reason, physician should take the total case taking and form the totality of symptoms, and then on the basis of totality of symptoms, he can prescribe the similar medicines to the patient and not the favorite remedies. Then a remedy is homeopathic not by its peculiar method of preparation but by the mode of its application according to the principle of symptom similarity between the drug disease and the natural disease. That is, a homeopathic remedy, that is, a remedy is homeopathic not by its peculiar method of preparation but by the mode of its application. Means, when we call it as a remedy, that is not by only preparation but by the mode of application according to the principle of symptom similarity, that is, between the drug disease and the natural disease. That is, when there is a similarity between the drug disease and the natural disease, then we called it as a remedy. A remedy is neither good nor bad for any particular disease condition. If it is homeopathic to the case concerned, it will be curative for that case. That is, if it is a homeopathic to the case concerned, it will be curative for that case. That is, when we select that simulimum medicine, then that simulimum medicine can cure the patient in all the way. So this is the sum of the explanation of these aphorisms, that is aphorism number 255 to aphorism number 258. So all of you understanding what is going on? Yes, all of you understanding? What I am speaking, all of you understand any difficulty regarding these? Utkarsha? यस उत्कर्ष कळते का काय चाललंय
हो मॅम यस मॅम
काय चाललंय
हॅलो
हां बोल ना
अमेरिकन आणि ते ग्रेजुएशन करा सांगा नाही
साइंस ऑफ अमेलिरेशन अँड साइंस ऑफ अग्रिवेशन की त्याच्यानंतर जे मी पाठ सांगितले अग्रिवेशनचे ते सो सायन्स ऑफ अग्रिवेशन अँड अमोलरेशन मध्ये त्यांनी दोन टाईपचे सांगितलेत. सायन्स ऑफ अमोलरेशन म्हणजे जर पेशंटला कधी वाटतं की त्याला बेटर फिलिंग आहे किंवा आपल्याला कसं कळणार आहे की पेशंटमध्ये बेटर फिलिंग आहे, तर त्याच्यासाठी त्यांनी सायन्स ऑफ अमोलरेशन आणि अग्रिवेशन सांगितले. तर सायन्स ऑफ अमोलरेशनमध्ये त्यांनी सांगितले की पेशंट हॅविंग अ ग्रेटर डिग्री ऑफ कम्फर्ट, पेशंट हॅविंग अ ग्रेटर डिग्री ऑफ कम्फर्ट, पेशंट हॅविंग इन्क्रीज्ड कामनेस, पेशंट हॅविंग फ्रीडम ऑफ माइंड, म्हणजे हे जे काही मेंटल स्टेट आहे किंवा फिजिकल स्टेट आहे या कंडिशनमध्ये पेशंट हॅविंग अ ग्रेटर फिलिंग ऑफ कम्फर्ट, म्हणजे आता मला बरं वाटतं ही फिलिंग पाहिजे, त्याच्यासोबतच इन्क्रीज्ड कामनेस पाहिजे, देन फ्रीडम ऑफ माइंड अँड हायर स्पिरिट्स, म्हणजे जो जे काही त्याचं वर्क आहे, जे काही डेली रुटीन आहे, जे काही त्याचं वर्क आहे, समजा जे काही नोकरी वगैरे करतो त्या कंडिशनमध्ये त्याला बेटर फिलिंग आलं पाहिजे. तर दीज आर द सायन्स ऑफ अमोलरेशन अँड देन दे एक्सप्लेन द सायन्स ऑफ अग्रिवेशन. सो इन साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन दैट इज अ कंस्ट्रेंट फीलिंग देन हेल्पलेस देन पिटिएबल स्टेट ऑफ माइंड अँड ऑफ द होल मॅन अँड ऑफ ऑल जस्चर्स पोस्चर्स अँड ॲक्शन. म्हणजे ॲग्रिवेशन आहे पेशंटमध्ये हे कधी कळेल आपल्याला की काहीतरी करू शकत नाही आहे मी काहीच करू शकत नाही आहे, मी हेल्पलेस आहे, पूर्ण नेगेटिव विचार जेव्हा पेशंटमध्ये असते तर त्या कंडिशनमध्ये आपण त्याला काय म्हणणार आहे, दॅट इज पेशंट हॅविंग अ सायन्स ऑफ अग्रिवेशन.
आले मैम आले
यस वी विल डिस्कसिंग द साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन इन साइंस ऑफ एग्रीवेशन देयर इज अ कंस्ट्रेंट फीलिंग देयर इज हेल्पलेसनेस और अ पिटिएबल स्टेट ऑफ माइंड ऑफ द होल मैन एंड द ऑल द जेस्चर्स पोस्चर्स एंड द एक्शंस म्हणजे पेशंटमध्ये अशी फीलिंग असते की मी काहीच करू शकत नाही आता याच्या पुढं काहीच होऊ शकत नाही आहे पूर्ण नेगेटिव्ह फीलिंग जेव्हा पेशंटमध्ये असते त्याच्यासोबतच त्याची माइंडचं जे डिस्पोजिशन आहे ते पण पूर्ण नेगेटिव्ह स्टेटमध्ये त्याच्यासोबतच जे काही बॉडी स्टेट आहे त्याचं जे काही जेस्चर्स आहेत पोस्चर्स आहेत किंवा ॲक्शन आहे त्याला सगळ्यांना काय येते एक लिमिट येते किंवा ते केल्यानं त्याला काय होतो त्रास होतो तर त्या कंडिशनला आपण काय म्हणतो दीज आर द साइन्स ऑफ ॲग्रीवेशन मग हे जर साइन्स ऑफ ॲग्रीवेशन आपल्या पेशंटमध्ये दिसत आहेत तर मग हे जे काही ॲग्रीवेशन आहे मग ते ॲग्रीवेशन कुठलं आहे कुठल्या टाईपचं ॲग्रीवेशन आहे आणि त्याच्यानुसार मग पुढं आपल्याला सेकंड प्रिस्क्रिप्शन काय द्यायचं हे ठरवायचं आहे तर त्याच्यामध्ये परत त्यांनी एक्सप्लेन केलं हाऊ टू आयडेंटिफाय वेदर इट इज ॲग्रीवेशन ऑर ॲम्युलरेशन बट वॉट टाईप ऑफ ॲग्रीवेशन मग ॲग्रीवेशनचे परत त्यांनी टाईप सांगितले मग त्याच्यामध्ये एक तर डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन असू शकतं एक तर मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन असू शकतं किंवा होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन असू शकतं मग याच्यामध्ये जर डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन आहे तर व्हॉट इज मीन बाय डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन सो दीज आर द इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ नॅचरल डिसीज सिमटम्स इंटेन्सिफिकेशन म्हणजे इन्क्रीज इंटेन्सिटी ऑफ दॅट सिमटम्स सो दीज आर द इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ नॅचरल डिसीज सिमटम दॅट वी कॉल्ड इट ॲज अ डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन मग डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन जेव्हा पेशंटमध्ये दिसतो तर त्याचे कॉजेस काय असू शकतात तर त्याच्यामध्ये त्यांनी फर्स्ट कॉज सांगितलं दॅट इज सिलेक्टेड मेडिसिन इज रॉंग जे काही मेडिसिन सिलेक्ट केलं आपण ते कसं आहे रॉंग मेडिसिन आहे किंवा जी काही पोटेन्सी आपण यूज केली ती कशी आहे लो पोटेन्सी आहे देन थर्ड कॉज दॅट इज ऑब्स्टॅकल्स आर नॉट रिमूव्ह देर आर सम ऑब्स्टॅकल्स इन द वे ऑफ क्युअर अँड दॅट आर नॉट रिमूव्ह सो दीज थ्री कॉजेस मे कॉजेस द डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन इन पेशंट देन सेकंड टाईप एक्सप्लेन ॲज अ मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन सो वॉट इज मीन बाय मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन मीन्स इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ द सिमटम्स दॅट आर रिलेटेड टू द मेडिसिन म्हणजे जे काय मेडिसिनचे सिमटम्स आहेत ते दिसून येतात पेशंटमध्ये हे जे काय पेशंटमध्ये सिमटम दिसून येतात ते त्याच्या डिसीज कंडिशनशी रिलेटेड नसतात जेव्हा मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन असतं तेव्हा मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशनमध्ये मेडिसिनचे एक्स्ट्रा सिमटम दिसून येतात आणि त्याचं काय होतं ॲग्रीवेशन होतं पेशंटमध्ये तर त्याला काय म्हणतो आपण मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन मग मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन कुठल्या कंडिशनमध्ये येऊ शकतं एक तर आपण हायर पोटेन्सी यूज केली पेशंटमध्ये तर किंवा आपण अननेसेसरी रिपिटेशन केले की रिपिटेशनची गरज नाही आहे ॲक्शन ऑफ मेडिसिन इज गोईंग ऑन आहे तरी आपण दुसरं मेडिसिन त्याच्यामध्ये रिपीट केलं किंवा सेम मेडिसिन काय केलं हायर पोटेन्सीमध्ये रिपीट केलं तर त्याच्यामध्ये काय दिसतील मग आपल्याला मेडिसिनल सिमटम दाखवाल जे काय मेडिसिन आपण दिला आहे तो तर ते काय झालं त्याचं मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन मग मेडिसिनल ॲग्रीवेशन पण इट इज अ बॅड इंडिकेशन डिसीज ॲग्रीवेशन इट इज ऑल्सो अ बॅड इंडिकेशन देन द थर्ड टाईप ऑफ ॲग्रीवेशन दॅट इज होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन आणि होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन म्हणजे काय दॅट इज देर इज ऑल्दो देर इज इंटेन्सिफिकेशन ऑफ सायन्स आणि सिमटम्स म्हणजे जे काय प्रेझेंट सायन्स आणि सिमटम्स आहेत पेशंटचे ते काय होत आहेत इन्क्रीज होत आहेत तर ते इन्क्रीज होत असतानासुद्धा पेशंटमध्ये काय असतं फीलिंग बेटर असतं तर दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन आणि होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन कधी येतं जर आपण दिलेलं मेडिसिन करेक्ट आहे दिलेली पोटेन्सी करेक्ट आहे देन रिपिटेशन आपण करेक्ट वेळी केलं आहे आणि ऑब्स्टॅकल्स आपण पूर्णपणे रिमूव्ह केलेत हे जर कॉजेस असतील तर आपल्याला काय दिसून येतो होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन आणि होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन इट इज अ गुड इंडिकेशन ॲज अवर रेमेडी इज ॲक्टिंग अँड वी आर ऑन द पाथ ऑफ क्युअर अँड दिस इज अ साईन ऑफ इम्प्रूव्हमेंट वन ऑफ द साईन ऑफ इम्प्रूव्हमेंट दॅट इज होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन अलॉंग विथ द इम्प्रूव्हमेंट इन द माइंड अँड डिस्पोजिशन अँड द फिजिकल बॉडी सिमटम्स ऑफ द पेशंट सो दिस इज वी कॉल इट ॲज अ होमिओपॅथिक ॲग्रीवेशन देन दे ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन रिगार्डिंग द फेवरेट रेमेडी दॅट इज द होमिओपॅथिक फिजिशियन मस्ट अवॉइड टू प्रिस्क्राईब द दॅट इज फेवरेट रेमेडी ऑर ऑल्सो वी कॉल इट ॲज अ स्पेसिफिक रेमेडी म्हणजे स्पेसिफिक डिसीज कंडिशन आहे त्याच्यासाठी लागणारी स्पेसिफिक रेमेडी असं होमिओपॅथीमध्ये आपण यूज करत नाही आपण होमिओपॅथीमध्ये पूर्ण केस टेकिंग करतो आणि टोटॅलिटीवरती जे सिमिलर मेडिसिन आहे ते आपण पेशंटला काय करतोय प्रिस्क्राइब करतोय. सो दिस इज रिगार्डिंग द सिम्पटम सिमिलॅरिटी अँड रिगार्डिंग द फेवरेट रेमेडी ऑर द स्पेसिफिक रेमेडी. अँड ॲट लास्ट दे एक्सप्लेन ॲज अ होमिओपॅथिक फिजिशियन मस्ट बी अन अनप्रिजुडाइज्ड ऑब्झर्वर. तो कसा पाहिजे? अनप्रिजुडाइज्ड ऑब्झर्वर पाहिजे. त्याचं एक्सप्लेनेशन तुम्ही ॲफोरिझम 6 बघितलेलंच आहे. सो दिस इज एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दीज ॲफोरिझम्स, ॲफोरिझम नंबर 255 to 258. सो ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टँडिंग एनी डिफिकल्टी रिगार्डिंग इट? मामीला मला वरती मुग आहेत. येस Yes, all of you understanding? So we finished these aphorisms. Aphorism number 244 to 258. That is related to the homeopathic posology. Sorry, 255 to 258. These are related to homeopathic posology. We completed these aphorisms. Yes, can you audible? Can I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So we finish these aphorisms, but we will take one lecture regarding this posology. What should be the selection of dose? What should be the selection of potency? Regarding posology only. So we will take it on next Monday. And after this, we finish the whole aphorisms from Organon part. मग सगळे aphorisms संपलेत, परत कुठले रिपीट करायचेत का? येत नाही आहे विजय तुझा आवाज मला क्लिअर. कुठले aphorisms रिपीट करायचेत का परत? किमोफिलॉसॉफी घ्यायची आता. करिश्मा मला अटेंडन्स पाठवशील?
मॅम तिचं नेटवर्क इश्यू झालंय.
बर बर. हां हां चलेगा. आज कम है, बहुत कम है आज. 12 to 13 ही है.
नहीं मैम, पहले हाँ पहले में थे और अभी नहीं है.
हाँ पहले भी इतने नहीं थे, बहुत नहीं है, मैंने ऑब्जर्व किया है. ओके चलेगा. सो वी विल एंड द मीटिंग नाउ.
यस मैम.
वन लेक्चर इज रिमेनिंग फॉर दिस पोसोलॉजी. आफ्टर दिस इफ यू वांट वी विल रिपीट द एफोरिज्म सम यू इफ यू वांट. Otherwise, we will start with philosophy. Yes, anyone want to tell anything?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so bye everyone.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, bye.